Was that you cracking your knuckles?
I thought just now?
Yeah,
a little bit.
I don't like cracking my knuckles. I don't do it.
What about your toes?
No, I don't crack anything.
I used to be able to crack my big toes, but then I got my bunion surgeries in 2008 and I've never been able to crack my big toes since. It's been very upsetting. Back to another episode of Two Gay Mats. It's Matt Steele.
It's Matt Palmer.
And JoJo's come out with an album again.
She's back, guys.
And god damn it.
I know.
I mean.
I know we did this recently and I liked the fun of it. What do you think my favorite
is? Your favorite song? Oh, I haven't even thought about what your favorite song
I know.
Song
I have to think about what your favorite song
god,
is.
Oh god, I don't know.
Do you have a clear favorite song?
I don't actually. Okay. Like, I really don't know what's my favorite. There's one that I find the most interesting, and then there are two that I'm just like, oh shit.
Okay.
Like, these two are probably the strongest. I really don't think I have a clear favorite.
I have a clear favorite.
I would assume it's Think About You.
I won't say.
Because, I mean...
I won't say.
And JoJo did it how I like it. It's a short album.
It is good.
I can't think of a skip.
I mean, like, no. She's really, you know, getting to the point.
Yes.
You know?
I would rather have a short album of no skips or very few skips than a long album of, like, amazing songs but, like, a bunch of skips.
I would rather that, but, you know, 9 is a little short for my personal taste. You know how I felt about the Robin album. And JoJo was around more recently than Robin was at that point. But even still, it's like... But when you have a voice like that, give us all you can, all you got.
She just wanted to give us a moment. She wanted to give us a mellow moment.
But then I wonder, what if there was a B-side that's as good as like a Joanna or something? Like, why is Joanna not on this album? What a song.
Joanna was just a buzz. It was a buzz moment. It was a moment for us to feel.
I was so buzzed.
But now we are talking about her new album, Good to Know, which dropped like an hour and a half ago. And I've listened to it twice already because that's how short
it's quick.
It is. That's how listenable it is.
Oh,
okay. Hey, are we gonna go track by
track? Let's go track by track. So bad.
JoJo is so bad. Like, girl, are you having an affair with a taken man?
Hey.
Girl, you know that's not right.
If Whitney does it on a song that people play at their weddings.
JoJo, I'm sad that you made this choice, but I'm glad that the song is so good because
it is excellent.
When that beat started, I was like, oh, we're done. Like, I want to have an affair with a married man. Like,
I know. You just want to be able to relate. I mean, obviously, the song is not something I would do personally, but
of course we're
sonically,
angels.
Of course, we've only been angels forever. But sonically, I would listen to this all live long day. And there's so much to this album, but I feel like this begins the arc of the album very well. Like, this song into Pedialyte.
Pedialyte, like, it's the most mellow song about alcoholism I've ever seen. Like, it's so chill.
And I love that freaking chanted chorus. I think it's so
freaking
catchy
good.
And so good. So now we know what era of JoJo we're in right now at this part. She's the partier. She's doing bad things. She wants attention from bad places and bad people. And she's, you know, there's always something to celebrate. She's like, I'm never going to drink again, but there's always something
to celebrate. And it's like, okay, I'll go out one more time.
Exactly.
And she's just like, oh, I had a hangover.
And it's also like, it's not like, oh, I'm going to go out and just like have a normal night with friends. It's like, I'm going out and then I'm up at 5 a.m.
Yes.
JoJo.
Yes.
I could never. I'm trying to think of the last time I was up at 5 a.m. and like, woo, I don't know if I'm just old, but I can't think of it.
Oh, in quarantine, I've definitely been up during 5 a.m.
Really?
Well, that's like when I do like a lot of my like really good work. And I'm like, oh, it's 5 a.m. Damn it. What did I do with my life?
I feel like I did come in very early one morning and you were still up.
That was a bad night.
I was like, oh,
that was a rough night.
I'm going to leave him.
That was when
alone.
I was having some technical issues editing.
Through the door, I could feel that. I feel like you've taken on the ability to express your emotions just via, you know, osmosis because I could feel it in the hallway. And I was like, okay.
But yeah, Pedialyte is the song that I found the most interesting.
I think it's interesting and brilliant, and definitely in my top four with Man. Man is also so good. Like, let's all remember.
Of course,
how good
Man.
We all
love Man. Yes.
Yeah.
Gold. Is it a really short song or a really long interlude? Like, it's really good.
It
like,
is
I
good.
Like it, but it's quite short.
Right.
So I don't think it makes as much of an impression as some of the other songs.
I agree with that. But I do love the like run in the chorus. I feel like it's
it's a chorus of a run.
It is. It feels like a Beyonce in beginning of Countdown run or something.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like if that was slowed down halftime, that would be the run that JoJo's doing. But it's lovely. It's excellent. And it definitely like feels very velvety, this song.
But I think it's placed well. Like,
absolutely.
In between Pedialyte and then, of course, Man, which you.
You know how we feel about
You've heard our review of Man. If you haven't, please check the video.
You should. And the thing is, I still love it.
It's
That's
great.
A single that I am not at all sick of, even though I've been listening to it for the past, like, what, 3 months, 2.5 months?
And months?
I feel like when did it come out?
Oh, I would say, like, a month ago tops.
No, it definitely came out before quarantine. 100%.
It did? Oh. Wow. But that's only like a month and a half.
Sure.
Like, we've only been in quarantine for like a month and a half.
Well, I guess the first time I heard it was.
Oh, that's right.
Was a couple months.
That's right.
Man is great and we still love it. Small Things. It's one of those songs that I feel like on paper has everything I would like. I love the message of the song. I love that it's like acoustic. I feel like it's definitely the most pop moment on the album.
Mm-hmm.
But for some reason I listen to it and think, I imagine this is what Tori Kelly's music sounds like, and it's kind of why I'm not interested.
All right, well, Matt Palmer, I'm gonna need you to stop talking. Because the second Small Thing started, I was just like, oh, this is gonna be great. It's like one of those songs where I was just like, oh, the first 5 seconds, I know immediately this works. This is great.
I think maybe sonically it just doesn't fit with the album. Like, it is so adult contemporary almost.
It does feel the most adult contemporary out of all the songs. I will say it does have a ever so slightly different feel, but like, I wouldn't say it's so jarring.
It's not completely jarring.
It's not so different from everything else.
It's just not the mood I'm in.
I loved it. I love Small Things. I think Small Things is great. My thought was,
I'm so glad she changed the single to Man.
Small Things was the single,
and then she changed it to Man.
Interesting.
Yes.
I love the verses because I'm just like, oh, girl, I know.
I mean, yes, and that's the thing. It's very relatable. We've all felt that, but I don't know. Sonically, it doesn't.
This is a bad opinion.
It is a true opinion. It's very Tori Kelly, and it's like, and I'm sorry if there are any fans of hers out there. And she seems like a lovely young lady, but I imagine this is what her music sounds like. It's like very light. I would call it light. Just very light.
It's a little light. It's definitely the lightest, most easy to swallow on the album, I would say. Still, your opinion is flawed.
It's not flawed. It is my opinion. That's my opinion! Lonely Hearts was a pre-release promo single.
Yes.
Very good.
Lonely Hearts, I was really into like when it happened.
Yes.
But now listening to the whole album, I'm kind of just like, oh, this might be my least favorite on the album.
Oh, I mean, I think it's, again, not as impactful, but certainly works, but it's not my least favorite. Small Things is my least favorite.
I think it just doesn't work for me,
but you know, definitely.
I mean,
overarchingly.
Like, objectively, this is one of her best
songs. I was gonna say, like, is this JoJo's best song? It is R&B, but it is the most melodic thing in the freaking world. It is interesting, it is beautiful, it is heartfelt, it is emotional, it fits sonically. It is JoJo firing on all cylinders. She sounds beautiful, she sounds perfect, she sounds flawless. I love Think About You.
Yes.
So much.
And just like, my friends are saying I should fuck someone.
Yes!
Every time I think about you.
That is the song. Yeah. That is the one that I'm like, you gotta put this out, JoJo. If you're out there listening, please.
This is the song. And she, everyone.
I mean,
knows.
We like, all must know.
Everything I've seen on Twitter is just like, think about you, and Small Things. But
Comeback is cool and sexy.
Comeback? Oh, girl.
Yeah.
Like, I feel violated.
Why?
Oh my God.
But it's so sexy?
Yes. Oh my God, I didn't know all these things were possible with a vagina.
I love that.
Flipping it back and forth like a spatula.
Hey.
Like, is that how it works?
I mean, I love that she's getting what she needs. And I love that, you know, it's a very, you know, I love a sexy song, you know, of a Janet moment. And I feel like this is her giving us that. And we love.
Oh, this is Janet.
I mean, I love it.
Yeah. Oh.
I mean, as a Janet listener, this is like, you know.
Oh, I needed a moment to breathe after this.
Janet goes, listen to Would You Mind, darling. We've all heard it. But then we get to.
Just sing.
Just sing! Yeah. Don't Talk Me Down is just such a masterstroke. Like, it's JoJo doing what she does best. It is clearly like we're doing the acoustic ballady moment, but this just feels soulful and focused and brilliant and heartbreaking. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, yes! I love this album because it is so consistent. It is so cool. I feel like it's very much in the Caution era of it, because it's like, we all know what you can do vocally, and you're not giving it to us all the time, because it's not really about that. I just want to take you on a journey, mm-hmm. let my beautiful voice guide you through the journey, but it's not an album of vocal powerhouse fireworks moments. Like, oh, yeah. That's not the point.
She's just like, I don't need to do that.
Yeah, you all know.
I can show you what a musician I am,
yes.
without like all the crazy tricks, yes. and everything, and all the songs are great.
So all it's the just songs like, are absolutely
that's
excellent.
What matters.
All right. So how do you feel, Mad Love versus Good to Know?
I mean, it depends on what mood
I know, they're very different.
Good to Know 100% is more consistent.
Oh, 100%.
Like absolutely. So great. Mad Love is, if I want a more poppy moment, yes. then I go to Mad Love. If right. I want a vibe, if I want to dance, you can't really, you know, rock out to this, you know. So, both excellent albums for yes. different reasons.
But this honestly feels more like the music JoJo wants to make.
Oh, 100%.
And so yeah. that's why it just rings so true and just feels like such an accomplishment, an achievement, and an absolute victory for her. So, I just urge us all to listen to it. Give JoJo her flowers. She's currently number one on iTunes in the R&B category. Mm. So, everyone keep buying it up. Keep listening on Spotify. Keep streaming. Because JoJo deserves the freaking world. I mean, I obviously will let it go one day, but she's been through so much, guys.
Yeah.
She's been through so much. Can we not just give her things?
Oh! And God, she's going through it all. She's up at 5 a.m.
I know.
She has a hangover.
I mean. Do you have anything else to tell the people?
That we love JoJo.
We love you.
Yes. Thank you so much for watching.
Yes, and listening. And make sure to follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Matt Palmer Music.
It's Matt Steele.
And at 2 Gay Match for both of us. Make sure to find our podcast, 2 Gay Match. You'll find it on Spotify and Apple Podcasts and our Patreon, patreon.com/2gaymats, where you can get extra bonus content from us regularly.
We love Adam Parnell. Parnell in Montana.
We love Adam Parnell in Montana. You know we do.
Yeah.
And we love every single one of you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Listen to JoJo when you can. We'll be back soon with another brand new 2 Gay Mats.
Bye.
Bye.